Hello everyone. As you people have requested, I read the comments. There are around like 102 comments in the video where I asked you to give your topics which you want me to make videos on. So I have chosen the few. They are repetitive. Matlab, most of the comments have common things which are asked for. तो आई हैव टेकन द फर्स्ट टॉपिक एज ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ स्टोमेटा. बच्चों ने बोला पोटेशियम आयन कंसेंट्रेशन पे बना दो एंड शुगर आयन पे. सो देर आर दे बोथ विल बी एक्सप्लेन फॉर ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ स्टोमेटा एंड इवन यू नो सम पीपल हैव सम चिल्ड्रन हैव आस्क्ड फॉर ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ स्टोमेटा ऑल्सो. सो आई एम मेकिंग दिस वीडियो जिसमें पूरा आई विल बी एक्सप्लेनिंग बोथ शुगर कंसेंट्रेशन थ्योरी एंड पोटेशियम आयन थ्योरी ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग ऑफ स्टोमेटा विच इज अ टॉपिक फ्रॉम योर चैप्टर फ्रॉम प्लांट फिजियोलॉजी. उसके बाद देर आर मल्टीपल अदर टॉपिक्स विच यू हैव आस्क्ड फॉर. आई विल बी मेकिंग एंड अपलोडिंग वीडियोज वन बाय वन फॉर ऑल द टॉपिक्स विच यू हैव आस्क्ड फॉर. सो वॉच द वीडियो टिल द एंड एंड प्लीज शेयर ऑल्सो. इफ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब प्लीज सब्सक्राइब एंड प्लीज शेयर माई बाय इन नीट चैनल एज वेल सो दैट द चिल्ड्रन हु आर गोइंग टू गो इन 11th एंड 12th दे कैन बी बेनिफिटेड. सो विल स्टार्ट नाउ. ओपनिंग एंड क्लोजिंग स्टोमेटा. There are two theories which explain opening and closing of stomata. Yes, both of them are not in practice and not many questions are asked from it. But yes, of course, there are many, many comments in other videos also. The children who are asking for this video. So I just wanted that I should make it once. So the first one is sugar concentration theory, and the second theory which explains the opening and closing of stomata is potassium ion theory. Now both these theories basically have, you know, many things in common, but still we'll talk about each of them one by one. First of all, sugar concentration theory. In this theory, I'll make the diagram also. So we are talking about the opening and closing of stomata. So I'll just make the structure of stomata here. This is the nucleus. Fine, we have multiple chloroplasts here. We'll talk about the working as well. Now, first of all, we'll talk day and night, how it happens. During day, sugar concentration theory we are talking about. During daytime, what is happening? The process of photosynthesis occur. We all know that chloroplasts, they have a lot of, guard cells, they have a lot of chloroplasts in them. There are many chloroplasts in guard cells where the process of photosynthesis is taking place. When photosynthesis is taking place, the end product formed is glucose. So glucose is formed in all the, in the guard cells to the maximum of its, you know, now more the number of chloroplasts, more photosynthesis, more glucose or more sugar formed. Now when the sugar concentration inside the guard cells increase, the solution inside the guard cells become, I'll write it here, glucose concentration increase, so the solution or the water amount or the water plus the sugar, the solution which is formed becomes hypertonic. Hypertonic. And if you remember osmosis, we all know that in the process what happens, the water has a tendency to move from its higher to its lower concentration. So if the concentration inside of the solution in this, if concentration inside the guard cells water concentration is less, so the water will start moving inside the guard cells. Why is the water from the surrounding cells moving inside the guard cells? Because the sugar level in the guard cells is more and water level is less. Fine. So as and when the water enters inside the guard cells, water enters and guard cells swell up and stomata opens. This is during day. This thing is happening during day. Opposite happens during night. What happens during night here? Night time, no photosynthesis takes place. There is no photosynthesis. So eventually the sugar concentration falls down. The solution now becomes hypotonic.
because the sugar is less now and water is more. So the water, according to its tendency, starts flowing out, which leads to the shrinkage of the guard cells, and hence the guard cells, they shrink, and the stomata, they just close. Fine. So this is how the sugar concentration theory works. During daytime, more photosynthesis, more glucose. The solution inside the guard cells become hypertonic. Water has a tendency to move from high to low concentration. So the surrounding cells ka water start moving in the guard cells, which leads to its swelling and leads to opening. Opposite happens during night. Now we move to potassium ion theory. What happens here? Again, we have the same diagram of the stomata to just explain you the things. Same concept happens or is taking place here as well. The process of photosynthesis, now we are talking about the daytime. The process of photosynthesis takes place. Now when photosynthesis is taking place, glucose is forming here. We are talking about glucose here. Here, during the process of photosynthesis, again ATP is also formed. We all know that. Energy is released. So this ATP, the concentration of the ATP inside the guard cells, it increases. Why? Because guard cells, it is undergoing photosynthesis. When the amount of ATP inside the guard cells, I'll write here in a flowchart so that it's easy for you to remember. So ATP amount increases, which leads to absorption of potassium ions from surrounding into the cell, into the guard cell. Guard cells. तो क्या होता है वहां पे water was moving inside, but water will also move inside. लेकिन उससे पहले क्या होएगा? When the ATP is concentration is more here, it will help the movement of potassium ions, increase the concentration of potassium ions, because बाहर के potassium ions will start moving inside the guard cell. When the potassium ion concentration inside the guard cells increase, again the solution becomes hypertonic. The solution is hypertonic, and the guard cells will start, or so water will start moving inside the guard cells, which will lead to its swelling and eventually opening up of the guard cells. What happens during night? Ulta. Simple. No photosynthesis, no ATP formation. When there is no ATP formation, potassium ion concentration decreases. When potassium ion concentration decreases, the solution inside the guard cells become hypotonic, and the water starts moving out from the guard cells, leading to the shrinkage of guard cells, and the stomata, they close. So very simple. None of these theories are followed nowadays, but yes, of course, they explain the opening and closing of the stomata. If you ask me, the questions which are asked from here is just, you can get the which theory explains to opening and closing of stomata, not more than that. So this is it. This is the explanation of opening and closing of stomata. We'll take up one more topic or a doubt next time, in my next video. So most probably I'll be talking about the experiments of plant physiology. I'll be making two videos for it, because it was also in lot of demand in many comments. So I'll make two. I'll make one for absorption by roots and transpiration, and second video for photosynthesis, because there are a lot of experiments ek mein covered nahi hoga. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.